Has only come to serve Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, whether he is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself.
Try to develop our chanting, remembering, hearing like this. So, we should try to come and try to bathe the mercy of Nityananda. So, Ar Kabeni Chander Karuna. And himself also. And this is the best qualified person in the whole world. And eat the teachings and name and order of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We will tell to them, and if they are turned into very bona fide devotees, then I will know the power of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And also, I will believe in name. That is so powerful. And he went to them and told, Om Jagai Madai. Chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
They heard, and in their ears it went on. And it was so much effect, but yet, these are the words. Nityananda Prabhu and Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur was so much far away from Nityananda Prabhu, and Nityananda Prabhu just came over. And with great and big eyes, the short person, oh, who are you? And then at once ran after Nityananda Prabhu, took a hold and They took their pot, earthen clay pot, and ran after them. Nityananda Prabhu. Right? He used to run so swiftly, fast. But Haridas Thakur Parsam fired, and he began to, like Dulia. Oh, Nityananda Prabhu is so mad. He has called the Ganjan Kirtan. But anyhow, they escaped. Patanjali Acharya was there. Haridas Thakur told them, oh, see, what this Nityananda Prabhu brought a very big danger, and we were to be killed there. No one was there to save us. Anyhow, he is lean and thin, so he escaped, ran away. But I was in danger. But by the mercy of Krishna, we are saved. From today, I will never go with him. And if I am going, then we will be killed. Then Advaita Acharya told, why you went with him? I know. There are two drunkards, Jagai Madhai, and also there are two more drunkards, Gaura and Nityananda. They are more drunkard than them. And I will see from tomorrow that four drunkards will be together and will drink more and they will dance and do. But you should not go. Then Haridas Thakur told, don't cheat me, Prabhu. I know. Gaura Nityananda are drunkard of praying. And they will rectify the two demons. And get, will give them a pot of divine wine, that is nectar. And all will be. Not only that, all Navadi will be made in Krishna. Next day, Nityananda Prabhu again went with Haridas Thakur, again did, and threw out one vessel, of wine. Nityananda Prabhu, I think your blood was coming. At once, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu heard from Krishna, and he came with lakh and lakh devotees and told, oh, where Chakri is? And Chakra came, and he was about to throw, but Nityananda Prabhu, don't do so. Ram, in the shape of Ram, in the shape of Krishna, in the shape of Nrisimhadeva, we have done all these things. We have killed, and then we have given the liberation all. But in this pastime, you should come. You should only change their heart and be merciful with pain in their heart, so that they can chant Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Gaur Praman, Hari Bol. They should chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. At once, miracle. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu impressed Jagai. I heard that you have saved Nityananda Prabhu. He was going to do more some nonsense. But he accept. And he, as he embraced, at once was full of Krishna fame and began to weep and rolling on the floor. But I told, oh, why you are giving prem to him? What I have done offense? Prabhu told, go to Nityananda Prabhu, and he forgets everything. And I will give you also Krishna. He at once held flight of the lotus feet of Nityananda Prabhu, weeping, crying, save me, save me. Then Nityananda told that forgiving everything. He requested Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is Krishna. And at once Chaitanya Mahaprabhu shot towards him and he became full of and began to cry and weep, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Ar kabe nitai shyamne karuna hai of Nityananda Prabhu, our heart will be clear from all kinds of worldly desires, from anger, kaam, krodh, lobh, mad, moh, matsarya, all these things. Six, these are six pain. And all kinds of offenses, all kinds of the things which are against bhakti principles. And then they will see how beautiful Vrindavan, cows are grazing everywhere, how hard wears with Krishna and Baldev, beautifully decorated with flowers, ornaments, and peacock feathers, having float on his lips and singing, dancing. Chants. You will see in Vrindavan, there is one Shiva. But Krishna with gopis, he dancing, singing so sweet on the bank of Yamuna. Yamuna is full of lotus flowers. We are coming there, telling Radhe Radhe, Jai Sri Radhe. Kakus are also singing, peacocks are dancing, Saint Krishna as a cloud. So, when we will see that, our destination is there, our aim and object of our Anand Sadhana is there. Not to be involved. Forever in four classes or third classes, first classes. Only reading A, B, C, D. We have to go up. Especially those who are senior, people to this. Go from Kanishta Vaishnava to go to Madhyam Adhikari. Perhaps you know Madhyam Adhikari. And after that, we'll have to go Madhyam, 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 Uttam, and then entering in Uttam Bhagavat. Monday we'll have the impact. After that, by the mercy of Nityananda, we will see. But only not Nityananda Prabhu mercy will not do. The mercy of Sanatan Prabhu, Guru Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami will do. All will come. Nityananda Prabhu, mercy is not so easily. We'll have to go to Nityan, first to Rupa and Raghunath, and by them, their mercy, Nityananda Prabhu mercy. Otherwise, no. That is very hard. The mercy of Nityananda. Right. Rupa Raghunath, mercy, we can know who is Nityananda Prabhu, who is Baldev Prabhu. What is Vrindavan? So if you want to know what is Vrindavan and what is Vrindavan, Krishna pastimes there, and to realize what is Seva Kunja, you know, perhaps you know the name of Seva. What is Seva Kunja? In all other places, Sudam Sikha, Shakha, Yasodamaya Ananda Baba, Sudam Subals, all are serving Krishna. In all places, gopis like to serve Krishna for Seva Kunji. A special place where Krishna serves Srimati Radhika. That is Seva Kunja. When Srimati Radhika and gopis become tired, Krishna comes and says, oh, you are tired, I am sleeping. Taking the Uttariya, Uttariya, you know, the Tambar, and washes them. Sweats. Oh, and I massage your feet. So here Krishna is serving. And if Srimati Radhika is gone, is something like anger. Then he gives a float in the lotus feet of Krishna, Srimati Radhika, and tells, if I have done anything wrong, you should forget. In Vrindavan, Krishna is not master, or Srimati Radhika is not master. But who is master? Pray. Viratka of Prem is the master in Vrindavan. Prem himself dance. And by this Prem, in supervision of this Prem, Krishna also dance, Gopi dance, all dance, Vrindavan dance, the heart of devotees dance, begins to dance, everybody. This is the mercy of Sridharu. And by that we can have the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu. Yog Maya Vrinda is everything. That Prem is highest thing. Prem Prayoga. Krishna Sambandha. Krishna, who is Krishna? Sambandha. There is some relation with Krishna. And then he is called Madan Mohan. And when gopis used to serve Krishna, then he becomes Govinda. So relation with Govind is to serve Krishna, like Sridham Subal or Ma Yashoda or like this is the highest thing. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to give this mission to Bhakti. Before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu there was only bhakti, no bhakti rash. Mathachat, Vishnu Swami, Nimbad, and Narad and all devotees, they used to do bhakti, but their bhakti was not bhakti of Russia. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and he gave this thing to Rupa Goswami and he gave to Raghunath Das Goswami. Then it became bhakti of Russia. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come only to give this mission to world and to test the Radha mood. Perhaps you know all with his great Chaitanya Chaitanya and Parthas Sausa Swami. This is by the most topest mission of Sri Chaitanya. Our whole disciplic orders or charge, like Rupa Raghunath, Jiva Goswami, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, Narottam Thakur, after that विश्वनाथ चक्रवर्ती ठाकुर बलदेव विद्याभूषण जगन्नाथ दास बाज महाराज भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर प्रभुपाद हिमसेल्फ अवर गुरुदेव एंड ऑल्सो स्वामी पीस मिशन एम एन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ दी अवर लाइफ नॉट ओनली अवर लाइफ बट एम एन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ अवर सर्विंग टू कृष्ण व्हाट इज दिस कृष्ण प्रेम प्रयोजन गोपीज आर अफेक्शनेटली सर्विंग कृष्ण They are also acting. And Krishna is serving gopis. He also loves gopis. And gopis love to Krishna. There are different two things. But we know from our gurus that Radhika or gopis' prem is so much superior, higher than Krishna loves her. Perhaps you are understanding or not, right? If you tell that again, because that my English is so poor and lame, I cannot give my
expression.
Name or
value? If they like, you can explain. And if we should do anything, that is all here. Why you have not done any management for this? Without the mercy of Rupa Goswami, we cannot have all these things what I told. You know, Rupa Goswami, Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam, Bhapitang Jena Bhutale, Swayang Rupah Kadamahiyam, Dadati Sapadantikam. Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam, Bhapitang Jena Bhutale. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has some desires here. Samud here, who is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? He is himself Krishna, that black Krishna. And he wanted to some test more what he has tested in Krishna pastime. What that was thing? Krishna thought that, I am so beautiful, but Radhika is more beautiful than me. I am so merciful, but Radhika is more merciful than me. I am also praying, but his prem is more. But yet, I know this. Radhika is my guru of prem. I was admitted in the school of prem school of Srimati Radhika. There are professors, Lalita, Vishakha, all their professors. So, my prem guru is Srimati Radhika. And that is why he sent Uddhava to take admission in Gopis' schools. Then he will know something about prem, and then he will return to Mathura, then I can talk with him, all these things. Otherwise, none is qualified to speak about prem, what is prem. So, there, Rupa Goswami has taken this mode, he went. So Krishna is thinking that the mood of Srimati Radhika is called actually Mahabhava, and more than that, Aruda Devuda and all these things. I am not that thing, but I see that I see Srimati Radhika, I meet Radhika, but I don't become mad. But when Srimati Radhika sees me, hears me, my flow, then she becomes mad, actually mad. Why? I think that there is something in me which makes Srimati Radhika and all gopis mad. So I have something here. What is that? But if I am not that mode of Mahabhava, I cannot test all these things. So I should borrow the mood of Radhika. I should serve and make please and to have to borrow that Mahabhava. And then I will realize, I will see myself, I will test myself like Srimati Radhika. And to give something to Jesus. Unnat Ujjvala Rasa. And that is called Anarapita Charing Chirat Karunaya Vatirna Kalo Shamarapai Tum Unnat Ujjvala Rasa Bhakti Harihapura Sundara Duti Kadamba Sandi Pita Sadaridaya Kandare Skuratime Sachinan. I will bestow something, sprinkle something from that. The Unnatva Ujjvala Rasa cannot be given to anyone because it is the more wealth of Srimati Radhika. It can be tested. So he came to test all these things and to give a sprinkle of Unnatva Ujjvala Rasa power to Jiva, for whom they may be qualified. So he gave it through the name Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare. Naam Prem Mala Gathi Parag Sabare. He made a garland of flowers. What that flowers? What that flowers? Shanta Dasya Sakya Vastal and all kinds. These are flowers. So different colors and big, different smells and all beautiful, sweet. And he, the sutra, said, what was said? Prem. And he said, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Naam is like flowers. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna like. So, he gave it to all these flowers by name. That prem was given. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to this world, and if Rupa Goswami was not there, anyone could not understand that why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to this world and what he is given to this world. Then Raghunath Goswami and all other Goswamis. So we are debted to Srila Rupa Goswami. Our whole disciplic line, after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, after Rupa Goswami is dedicated to Srila Rupa Goswami. Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati came to begin this mission work. He has so many thousands and thousands of hands, like Mahavishnu. His one hand came from India here. Very long, long hand. And what was his hand? His hand first has mercy to this land, and we will go tomorrow to that land. Krishna consciousness, it touches to this world. western body, here. That, and that has name is called Swami, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami, and you call all like Prabhupada. And this has been so generous, so gentle, so sweet. And godless mercy he has. We cannot glorify him because we don't know that prem. If we knew that prem, then we can have glorified. What we are doing, telling, or he has praised name. It is not such enough. You will have to know that Rupa Goswami view. You know that one thing. Tava katha amritam tapta jeevanam kavibhiriritam kalmashapaham shavarna mangalam shimadatatam bhuvigridhanti te bhurida jana. It is from Rashpanchadhyayi Visheshwara. Gopi began mad telling this. Also Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, hearing this slok in Puri from the mouth of Pratap Rudra, he told, who is he that he is making here and getting so much nectar in my ears? Who are you? His eyes were closed and tears were coming. And he had like a mad person. He told that, I have nothing to give you. Nothing. I am akinchan. I am so much poor. I have nothing to do, but only I can give you my embrace. And he embraced him. And with tears he washed him. So this sloka is so good. Those who are telling all these things to us without anything, not taking anything in gain, only by mercy they are giving Krishna Katha to us. Indeed, they are Gurida Jana. Gurida means in this world they are most super donor. Donor?
Magnanimous.
Benefactor. Magnanimous. What word?
Magnanimous.
Generous.
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 So much generous.
Those who have only a book named Srimad Bhagavat here, having good Sikha here, having three folded Tulsi Mala, tears are coming, and speaking these slokas and telling that you should also chant Krishna name. He is so much generous in the whole world. So Swami was like this. Anyone has not called him, his Gurudev sent him. And he mercifully came to this land, where only wine, wealth and what? Women were prominent. He came here. All ones to make money, 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 money. Nothing else. And formally sense gratifications. They don't know who is Atma, who I am. Why I have come to this world? What is our duty? And where to go? No passport, nothing, no visa, nothing. In darkness we are sinking. Mercifully he came to this land. And if you do, you know that how miracles in a very little, some days he changed. So many devotees like you, not only you, hundreds and thousands of devotees. Those who were happy, they became happy. Those were lying down and taking mine, I came and I saw something I knew. they become all happy who were touched by even his words. So he is most generous. So this only one hand did some miracle, and if 2, 3, 4 handers then even come, then what miracle could have been done? I cannot explain. So, without the mercy of Rupa Goswami, we cannot see Vrindavan and hear all these things. He has given everything in his books. But you know, that when there is a child of 5 years, or 2 years, even 1 year, he cannot be given everything. His father or mother gets something in box and locks. Then he will be, when he will be matured, then he will be qualified for taking all these things. If he will give anything, he will ruin everything. So he let him some mature. So, by words he could not give them all these things. But if he kept everything in his treasure, that is in literature, in his books, he should try to open. But you know that the key is in the hands of Bhagavat. There are two Bhagavats, Granth Bhagavat and Bhagavat is superior. But the key is with devotees. So that anyone is one of high devotees, surrendered devotees, having shamed in the version of this frame, he can open the door. So, he has kept everything which Rupa Goswami has in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu and all books. I have never read all the books because I did not know English. I have not gone to university and I have read only in Haridas Thakur University. You know Haridas Thakur University? Only in the schools of Srila Gaurakula Sovdas Baba. He don't knew A, B, C, D. So I am like this. So I could not. But now, in the touch of these devotees, I am speaking very little and also understand. I can read. Now I read. I see now that heart, he has given all the treasures. Upadeshamriti is there. The purpose of Swamiji, you can see all the things which were we can see in Rupa Goswami. So I am always fond of the Rupa Goswami and Raghunath Goswami. And tell something about this. In what process we can go to Vrindavan and follow Rupa Goswami? But some persons are telling them, oh, we are not qualified, we were not qualified, and we will never be qualified to hear all these things. But I think that it is quite wrong. He has kept up for us, when we will be matured, qualified, that we can taste and we can go to that place. Why Rupa Goswami has written, why Krishnadas Goswami has written, why Vyasadeva has written this Bhagavatam? For us, for coming generations. So, by the mercy of Rupa Goswami, we can know all these things. What was the mission of Rupa Goswami? And mercifully he came to feel the heart. Without any invitation he came. I know that when he came and he wrote me a letter that I am reached here by navigation, Cynthia navigation, and I am going to some park with my only Tata, and I sing there Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityam Sri Advaita Gadadhar Shivas Adisi Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar. 300 letters she gave to me. I know him from 1946 or 1947. I was so much touched to him. I have served him when our Gurudev Nityalila Pravishta Om Vishnu Vasishnu Bhutri Siddhanta Bhakti Pragyan Kesha Goswami was giving him a renounce order. I know many, so many things. I have arranged everything there. I have sent him old Katal, Matang and his all books here in New York. After so much labor, I became ill at that time in sending all this. I have cooked for him. I have served so many ways. Sometimes he used to write me that, oh, I like Mathura Peda. Peda is a very beautiful, sweet. And I used to send him 10 kilos, 10 kilos, 10 kilos. I have sent him so many ditties of Radha Krishna and Gaur Nityananda. So many pairs. When he used anything to require, I used to help him. He told me that you should come with me here. I very honorably told that I am now serving my Gurudev. And he is not here, he is in Bengal and charge of all. So later on, I made my team. It was just used to serve. But I know that his words will not be false. So after so many years, he has dragged me here. I have only come to see how miraculously, in very short time, he has spread his mission to the whole world. His books have been translated in 40 languages of the best languages of all the world. His Gita, his so many little booklets have also been everywhere. He has made so many center, preaching center. He also told me that I have now established Krishna consciousness, international Krishna consciousness. I believe so. So now I have come to see these places. These places are pilgrimage, not only that Mahamahatirtha. So I have come to touch the lotus dust of Swamiji here, to glorify him, and also to help the devotees who have been neglected. I've heard that, and become so worried that so many, 90% of devotees have left ISKCON. I want that they should again come, and Krishna consciousness be so pure, and again with the same enthusiasm, this so display. I've come to serve them, I've come to help them, and to see all these things. I've not come to create any problem or anything to anyone. I was in this mood, I'm in this mood, I will ever in this mood. I've not come to collect money, I've not collected any disciple, nothing else. But if all this problem, my mission. I think my mission is so successful. My last pilgrimage is in New York, where he used to, in any park, and he used to sing this kirtan. I must go there. Tomorrow morning we will go. I pray all, I request all to be there at 7 o'clock in morning with so many kartals and kholes, mridangs. He will go and dance and serve Swamiji. He will see here and he will see that we are all there in their rank. He will be so happy. So, Rupa Raghunatha Pane Deya Kuti
Yeah.
special mercy of Rupa Goswami and Raghunath Goswami. You will know what is pastimes of Krishna and Srimati Radhika. What is called kunja, groves. When we will hear the melody of that throat, only by the mercy of Rupa Goswami. We will have the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu, and by that we can know all these things. But what is Jugal Priti? Jugal Priti means divine couples, divine love. We are not realizing, not thinking, going deeply, so we are not. We are involved in worldly, toxic expression or anything. We know that we have known so much faith that name can give everything. So we are trying so much here and there to make money, to make pratishtha, to make our knowledge more, so we are going to colleges and everywhere to become PhD, DD. We have no faith. Other people faith, like Srinivas Acharya, you know, Srivas Pandit, once he clapped like, 1, 2, 3. Mahaprabhu told him, why you are clapping this hand 3 times? 1, 2, 3. He told that, you are asking me that you have nothing to take anything. There are no rats in your homes. You know where rats are found. Then, but you have no grain, so rats are not there. And rain falls, every raindrops goes to his home. Because no roof at all. You have no water pot. You have nothing. So how you will maintain your life? He told me, 1, 2, 3. I have nothing to eat. Nothing to have a Mahaprasad. I will fast 1 day. Second day also. Third day, I will fast. And if for today nothing, then I'll jump in Ganga and give up my life. Mahaprabhu told that. Nothing to work to worry. If Lakshmi himself, Lakshmi means the goddess of fortune, wealth, if he will take some pots and beg door to door, but you will have had not to beg anywhere. Because those who are chanting name is himself Krishna, the husband of this Lakshmi. Who is the Lakshmi husband? Narayan. And Narayan is the manifestation of that Krishna. Not Krishna, but Baldev. And Baldev is the manifestation of this. So Krishna is supreme, and who are telling and chanting Krishna, they cannot be hard. They cannot die without. Krishna will come and take something on his head, and he will get to them. You know one history, that there was a devotee named Arjun Mishra. He was so poor. He had nothing to eat, nothing to, but anyhow he used to go to beg. One day he was writing something, explanation of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, and this slope came. Anna, ananna, chintayanto mangje jana pratipasate yogachema bhamya. This slope was that those who were engaged totally in chanting, remembering Krishna, hearing me, the pastimes of Krishna, I will go and serve them what they want. If they want food, I will go and carry this food to them. If they want clothing, I will go and serve them. Everything I will go. He cut that line that Krishna cannot come because he has no shape. Why would he come? He can give inspiration to others, then he can bring. But Krishna will not come himself. And so he take a red pen and went to wait. But today, nothing was received. He returned empty-handed. And he was about to come. In the meantime, a very little boy, aged only 12, so beautiful. This was like clouds, and very sweet speaking, he came and called, oh mother, open the door. At once the wife of that Brahmin came and opened. He saw that there was a very little aged boy, so beautiful. And he was taking bath from sweats. And he was so tired. He told the sir, who are you? I'm the disciple of Gurudev. He got that nickname, but he told that I'm Gurudev. And Gurudev has sent all these things, so much atta, flour, rice, chawal, dal, ghee, maida, bhura, sweets, milk, everything he has. I could not carry. It became late. Then he took a crash. Why you are making late? Go at once. See my bag. And bag, he saw that. About red cloud was coming. She became furious and let he come and he will come. I will rebuke him. Why he did so? He told that, oh boy, come in. And I am making some preparations and after taking, you should go. Otherwise, no. Yes, I am waiting. And he began to take something from that and he began to prepare good chapati with ghee, a chawal, dal and all others. In the meantime, the Brahmin came and told them, oh, open the door. He went furious there. Why you have done so mistake? Given so much weight and load to this boy? Who is the boy? He is sitting in your disciple, so beautiful, aged about 12, very fit, beautiful and sweet. Oh, I have no disciple at all. Who has come? Will you come on? And he went and began to search, but he was not there. Who was he? He was Krishna. They both began to be. And Brahman brought his book, told that I bring my that book. And he saw that their reddish line was vanished. Gone. To make him understand that what is Gita is all true. So we should faith on Krishna name. Name Krishna name can't give anything. It is more merciful than Krishna himself. But we have no faith like this. Haridas Thakur has so. All the Goswamis have this faith. We should try. Then if having so much faith, then only Krishna chanting like Haridas Thakur 3 lakhs and always remembering him and everything will come and we will conceive Vrindavan. So we should pray to Rupa Goswami. Rupa Raghunatha Pade Prabhu Swamiji also. So I honor him and I want that he should give some teachings and we should follow. He can also glorify his Gurudev, how sweet he was, how generous he was, how merciful he was. He can tell also.
Maharaj is always my well-wisher. He's always putting me in some position so I become purified and humble. He's also flattering way beyond reality. He's good for about my purity.
Microphone.
We can't hear you.
Sorry. Maharaj says he doesn't know flattery, but I disagree with him. He's flattering me by saying Maharaj is pure Vaishnava. He has many times flattered me. Most astoundingly, once he called me his old colleague. I'm very happy that somewhere he's included me in his entourage. Maharaj spoke many wonderful things. I know everyone couldn't hear everything that he was saying, but there are tape recorders here, and there are many devotees. I seem to recall something similar that our Guru Maharaj, Swami Maharaj A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada was saying in relation to how this Brahmani has cut off the sloka and then this has come. So this is, Srila Prabhupada was saying like that, maybe someone like Chadarani would remember. I don't remember exactly, but the words of the Mayavadi, they are like the whip on the body of Krishna. Actually, he cannot be whipped, but still, we are saying that he has cut with the red pen, so the red line. So who gives this impersonal commentary to Bhagavad Gita by his speech? His speech is very cutting. Very painful to Krishna and more painful to the devotees. The devotees cannot tolerate that. So we're very happy that Maharaj has come to New York. He has saved the best for last. I told him, you're going, Maharaj, to the Big Apple. Big Apple. This is the Big Apple, Maharaj.
Yes.
So Swami Maharaj came first to the Big Apple. Began his preaching mission here. It has always remained as a special place in the hearts of all the devotees worldwide. So about Srila Prabhupada's coming here, I want to say something in relation to that. It is about seva, service, and service necessity, or the necessity of service. When service becomes most valuable. There are many branches of service. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Smananam, Vandanam, Dasham, Sapyam, Atmanivedam. Nine branches in devotional service. These are performed by devotees in various stages of devotional service. And we are studying that in our books. But more importantly is that we try to follow that. And Maharaj is told, one cannot remain a Kanishtha Adhikari forever. It's absolutely no credit to our Guru Maharaj to say that we are always on the lower level. Absolutely no credit to him. Only we can give credit to our Guru Maharaj when we come to the higher level. There is no question of being a Prabhupada Nuga or a follower of A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, or for that matter, even a follower of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, or a follower of any acharya in our sampradaya unless one has become Rupa Nuga. Unless we have become a follower of Sri Rupa, we have not really become a follower of our Guru Maharaj. Is it right, Maharaj? His message is to make us Rupa Nuga. Actually, we can say Prabhupada Nuga, but this is not pleasing to him. I never heard any disciple of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur tell, we are Prabhupada Nuga. They are told we are Rupa Nuga.
Same wine
in different bottle. A miracle done your divine grace, Srila Prabhupada wrote. And so, service is valued according to the necessity. Krishna does not like complacency amongst his devotees. And that is our all-time classic disease here in the Western world. We become complacent. Oh, Prabhupada gave so many books. We don't need more. But actually, who's reading those books? And even who's reading those books, which sections of those books are we reading? We're reading Chaitanya Charitamrita, but which section? Mahaprabhu eating much prasadam in the bags of Raghava Pandit. This one we're reading. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu touring South India, going from place to place to place, spreading Harinam. But Ramananda Samvad, that we're not reading. The talks of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu actually there are five conversations. Ramananda Samvad, Rupa Shiksha, Sanatana Shiksha, Prakasananda Saraswati, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. Five conversations. That is that philosophy. People are telling us that is philosophy. But without that philosophy, we will not become eligible to taste any ras or any prem. And when that philosophy comes, then we're yawning. We have something to do, some place to go. There are 100 slokas in the Chaitanya Charitamrita that have come from the very lips of Sri Radhika and Lord Govinda, but we are not reading them. And when reading them, we're falling asleep. Then we're telling everything is in Prabhupada's books. Then we have got some type of lethargy. To break that lethargy, and Krishna is sending his men. Maharaj has come to help us break this lethargy. Srila Sridhar Maharaj, our Shiksha Guru, he used to say, you are sons of nectar. You are born of nectar. You are meant to taste nectar. Where are you without nectar? Simply on the desert of material existence. So it does not suffice to say, we have enough, we have enough. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu never told like that. Mahaprabhu did not say, oh, I have so much. He may have said, oh, I had, now I have lost that. Six Goswamis are roaming through Vrindavan. They are wandering, always searching. What is the slok? Hey, Rad, hey, Rajadeva, Picha, Lalite. And our Srila Prabhupada, he came here chanting that sloka. He came here singing Sat Goswami Astakam.
And weeping.
Once I heard my god sister Jadarani, 2-3 years ago, I went to a Gaur Purnima festival in Mayapur. Not as an official member, but I wandered there in the night. What are you laughing at? So there was a Prabhupada memorabilia night, and many devotees assembled in a pandal. So I just sat in the corner, somewhat in the shadows in the evening, and watched the proceedings. Many older devotees were there, and one godbrother, previously from Australia, Madhuvisa Prabhu, He was the
master of ceremonies,
giving the microphone to various devotees. And each and every, at least on that night, each and every remembrance of Srila Prabhupada resulted in laughter. Resulted in laughter, in happy times, and good remembrances. By and by, the microphone came to Jadaran. Then I thought, I must hear something more from Jadarani, because she has come in the association of our Sri Padmarayana Maharaj. So she must say something more than what we've heard so far. And I was recalling also that just that very day, I had gone to darshan to our Bhakti Pramod Puri Maharaj at his ashram at Gopinath Gorinma. And I asked him something about Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And just mentioning the name of his Guru Maharaj, he entered into very, very deep mood. Actually, I asked him, are there any tape recordings of Saraswati Thakur? He became very intense in his mood of remembrance of his Guru Maharaj. He looked at me like I was the grand fool on the earth, and he told me, Baba, Guru Maharaj Saraswati Thakur is here in front of us always. So that evening I was remembering that incident with Srila Prabhupada Puri Maharaj. So I thought, what type of remembrance is it of our Guru Maharaj that always ends in laughter? That is not sufficient, actually. Although we will remember these happy times, but long after his departure, we should try to remember something very substantial and very deep about him. So then our Jadarani began to tell his story, what Srila Prabhupada told her, maybe 1967. It was a story about Jayadeva Goswami, who was writing Gita Govinda, and he began to write a verse. That verse begins, Dehi Pada Parashtha. Then he thought, what is this? Where does this impure thought come from? He abandoned his writing. This sloka also telling, as Maharaj said, what is Seva Kunj? How Govinda has served the lotus feet of Sri Radhika and Gopis. So like that, in a very strong way, Krishna is begging desperately Srimati Radharani for her forgiveness and for her foot dust. So Jayadeva Goswami thought, what is this? Since some impure thought has come within me, he abandoned his writing. Srila Prabhupada was telling the story to Jadarani, and as the story was unfolding, at least it was my perception that she was trying to take the remembrance beyond just the normal remembrance. That actually our Guru Maharaj came here with something very sweet and very divine, but he could not find the proper ears to receive the full-fledged meaning of his message. If someone studies analytically the tapes and the activities of our Srila Prabhupada, he begins talking about Vrindavan, Sri Rupa Goswami, Radha Govinda. You just see even those recorded lectures on Radhastami, and you will see a gradual progression from the higher to the lower. Until his last day, simply he's telling, life comes from life, not from matter. You understand what I'm saying? He came with the message of Sri Rupa, but the Adhikari to hear that and to understand that was lacking. So according to the necessity, he gave and he gave and he gave and he gave. And in his last breath, actually, he was giving Bhaktivedanta Institute and arranging so many things, how the scientists should come to this understanding that life comes from life, not from matter. But we are thinking that this is a sum and substance of Krishna consciousness. Vegetarianism, life comes from life. You're not this body. Karma. These are all Mayavad and Buddhistic theories also. Jayendra Saraswati of Kanchipuram, he'll agree with you 100% on that. Furthermore, we are now telling everyone that we came from the eternal pastimes of Krishna to rot here in this material world. And Jayendra Saraswati at Kanchi, first class, he will agree with you. Yes, you're Golok, Your Vaikuntha, it is a fallible place. It is wrought with disaster. But our Brahma, then you will find the ultimate peace, ultimate rest. Basically, the principles in Mayavad and these things, this is not Krishna consciousness, actually. Even our four regulative principles, we wouldn't think to live without them, but you can follow them till the end of time and not produce any Krishna bhakti. Any Krishna bhakti whatsoever. But same time, if you want to be sahaja and rascal and do all nonsense things, still, we will not see Krishna bhakti there either. We give the example of Pundarik Vidyanidhi. He would become guru of Gadadhar Pandit. When Gadadhar Pandit first came to see him, what he saw? Pundarik Vidyanidhi had a turban, jewels, costly perfumes, beautiful bungalow, smoking a hookah also. Gadadhar Pandit thought, thought only. What type of a Vaishnava is this? No kundimala, no sika, no tilak, no trappings and dressings of the Vaishnava. Oh, suddenly there he possibly made some offense. And then Maharaj, who was by his side? To take him there. And Mukunda chanted one sloka from Bhagavad.
Ahobakim.
Then you can find these slokas. I'm not good at remembering many slokas. Please excuse me. But then he saw a transformation in Pundarik Vidyanidhi. He became mad, throwing his turban from his head, breaking his cloths and his jewelry, smashing his water pot, pounding his feet, and crying. Oh, what is the wonder, what is the mercy of my Lord? Because he has given such great mercy to the Putana demon. She has come to kill Krishna. But he is so kind. She has come as mother. He has extracted little bit of reality from her approach, and he has given her all success in Vatsalya Ras. So then Gadadhar Pandit realized, oh, this is a Vaishnava. But generally, the Vaishnava is coming like Maharaj. He is in good dress and tilak and sikka and showing us the way in that way. But that is not the standard of a Vaishnava, only these rules. Only, we are telling everyone, simply chant 16 rounds daily, follow the four regular principles. You will develop the perfection of life. Yes, that is true, because if you do that sincerely, that will lead you to other stages in Krishna consciousness. And then your life goes upside down and goes backwards, and so many problems begin to happen. You have to leave so many things in order to achieve that. So Krishna very much values the service of his devotees according to necessity. And one who is preaching amongst the devotees, Krishna says, is very dear to him. And one who comes to awaken us from our lethargy in Krishna consciousness and to pursue vigorously the lotus feet of Krishna at Vrindavan, not just anywhere. We're of a particular type of devotion, devotion in Vrindavan. We're not for Dwarka, actually. We're not for Vaikuntha. One devotee recently said to me, if I can get Vaikuntha, I'll be very happy with that. I said, why? You are a Prabhupada man. You're always telling me, you are the Prabhupada man. I am the outside man. But I can tell you that Prabhupada is not in Vaikuntha. So why you want to go to Vaikuntha? And also Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not in Vaikuntha. And Nityananda Prabhu is not in Vaikuntha. So how can we be satisfied with Vaikuntha? We cannot be satisfied. Satisfaction is our enemy. We must always hanker more and more in the line of Sri Rupa. That was the teaching of A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Not simply chant, dance, and be happy. It is happiness. Someone told Swami Maharaj looks very sad in one photo. He told, no, it is great happiness.
Okay.
No. So, what service Maharaj is doing for our Srila Prabhupada and for the mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu for coming on this world tour in his advanced age and taking all difficulties? He's getting supreme mercy. He's getting the mercy of his Guru and his Guru Varga. He's getting the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Sri Nityananda Prabhu, whole Panchatattva, all members of the Gaudiya Sampradaya giving mercy, and all members of Goloka also giving their mercy. So what we should do, Maharaj will go away in a few days. Again become complacent? Oh, I have heard from Sadhu. Yes, we have heard from Sadhu. Now we must become thirsty after that. Many of you should take the opportunity and follow immediately to India. Those that cannot should group together, make your Sangha. And not simply for what we call dollars, diplomacy, and despotism. Not for these things, but for the real purpose of Krishna consciousness. Saraswati Thakur once said at a Mayapur function, so many people came, very nice speeches. Of course, Maharaj may not say that now, but Saraswati Thakur said, please, now don't cheat me. Maharaj has put before you the wares of the spiritual world. Those things which Prabhupada said don't show to people, ordinary people. He has put a sample of the very high wares that are being sold in the marketplace of the holy name, where Haridas Thakur is the supreme acharya, where merchants are Rupa and Sanatana and Maganadas and Bhakti Manoa Thakur. He has shown the wares. But it is sad that in the name of Srila Prabhupada, many people are denying these things. One very old devotee said, you know, those are the people who say that serving Radharani is more important than serving Krishna. So I thought, well, which camp do you belong to? Maybe he's with Chandravali. And let me just say one little thing before I stop talking. Maharaj, in this place, there is Radha Govinda. Maybe we cannot see, but there is Radha Govinda, deities that Swami Maharaj brought here. And he called it as Radha Govinda. No, this one's, no. The little ones. The little ones you sent. Then one big ones, the Gayatri Devi, Rajmata at Jaipur, at Govindaji's temple, in the Mahal, in the palace, she had some big deities of Radha Govinda. And when Swami Maharaj made a program there in 1971 or two, then she was very charmed, and she gave those. Then they came from here. Then brought it over. So anyway, I don't want to cheat you more because I'm taking Maharaj's time also. Enough time. So maybe there's some questions devotees would like to ask Maharaj or whatever you desire.
I'm so much fortunate to serve Swami Maharaj in so many ways. In his last days, that she was there, so many devotees were there, he called me, I went there. The very day when he was departing from this world to his Master Radha and Govinda Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda. And he took my hands in his hand, waiting something. And he told that I am so happy to have you. I have some wishes, you can fulfill it. I want that you should give my samadhi within your own hands, with Vedic mantras. I know that you are so much qualified and experienced in these things. There were so many god brothers of Swamiji and all senior JBC members also were there in front of me. He told me. He also told that after my going, will also manage my last Mahotsav, year of my separation festival. You also advise them to give some donations to all the temples as you like. What should be given? Yes, it depends on me. One thing more I want to you, that you should be always helpful to my disciples. I brought them from various countries from whole world. But I know that they are like child. You should support, you should nourish them, and we should try to train also them. I told that I am your disciple. I know that you are my Shiksha Guru from very beginning. So I will carry your all orders. I am fortunate to carry your orders my head. And after that, when I came from there, he could not speak a word to anyone. This was the last words, and he departed from this world forever. But I know, I told that all the disciples were there, that you should not think that he has left his body and he died. Face, even today here, if you will show honorable and sincere, he will inspire you in all these things, and his mercy will come to you. So don't think that he is dead. He is still alive, and he is forever he is here. So then think that we have become orphan. He is so merciful, and he will get mercy inspired here in India. So you should try to fulfill his mission, what he has begun. I think that his mission is more to do. He has done something, and something he has left as a remnant for you. So as a remnant, you should serve him and carry his orders. Don't quarrel among you. Don't misbehave any god brother. Try to honor all who have taken shelter of his lotus feet, and they should be honored. Otherwise, everything will be ruined. Don't criticize each other. Swamiji told that, oh, listen, what good things he has given to you, you should remind of all these things. So I am so much fortunate to carry his, I followed his, carried his orders. I gave him Samadhi and also millet, everything. And when some case came against, court case, I fully supported this. I've never told any word against them. I will never. I will always help them. I will always help my Swamiji, like my Gurudev Srila Bhakti Pragyan Kesava Goswami. I know that they are both from same rank. Shiksha Guru and Diksha Guru are same. We should try to honor both, all the Vaishnav also. If you want to serve Swamiji, don't criticize any Vaishnav who is even in Kanishta Vaishnav. If he is the disciple of disciple, even he, they should be honored. Because there are family of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, family of Swamiji. And if you are not following all these things, his teachings, then we are not serving Swamiji accurately. So we should try to honor him, not to do Guru Avagya. If you are not following all these things correctly, that you are doing Guru Avagya. This is the honor of Swamiji. So we should know all these things. I am happy to hear Nrisimha Maharaj. He told so beautiful things. And I am seeing that Swamiji has brought me here. to show his all the things which has done so miraculously. So I'm thinking that my mission is successful. Vaishnavas from various places have went through. And I'm requesting them that you are devotees, pure devotees, you should show me where Swamiji used to see, where he used to sing, where he did hippies to happy, where he was here. I want to hear and to know all these things because senior disciples like him, there are so many disciples. Where is Satyaraj Prabhu? I request also Satyaraj Prabhu to lead me and to tell me where and how and help me also. I want to take the fittest of Swamiji here. So I want to request all to do kirtan there with so many mridangs, kartals. We go and dance and see and serve Swamiji and go pramanandri. Any kirtan? Where is? You should come at once.
Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara